Mom.
Hey, sweetie. Just calling to check up on you. What are you up to?
Nothing much. I was just watching a movie.
Have you eaten yet?
Nope. I'm on a no-food diet. It's like a no-carb diet, but a lot more effective.
Honey, that's not safe. You need to eat.
I'll pass. No, not yet.
Jeez, Lauren, you think he'd be a lot more cautious considering all your friends got killed at school last year.
It doesn't matter. It's not like I'll be killed off. I'm a fan favorite. The fans say I remind them of Carlson Young's character from Scream.
Well, I still think you should lock up before you head to bed. Just to be safe. I don't feel comfortable knowing that Emma girl is still out there.
Don't worry, Mom. I'll lock up as soon as I hang up with you. All right, bye.
Bye. Love you, sweetie.
Love you, too. Mom, I'm currently locking all the windows and all the doors. Don't worry.
You sure that's a good idea? What if there's a killer already in the house?
Okay, you know what, asshole? I'm getting tired of these stupid, immature prank phone calls. Yes, I'm the sole survivor of the murders that happened last year at Fine Arts LA. Get over it.
Don't flatter yourself, doll. Not everyone is impressed with you as much as you think, you self-absorbed bitch. Let me ask you this, Lauren. Do you think everyone would still love you if they knew who you really were, what you're really capable of?
What are you talking about?
Just to think. All those people that died last year, you should have been the first one to get killed.
Okay, I'm not liking this at all. I'm calling the police.
Go ahead. I doubt they'll send patrol calls over for a stupid, immature prank call.
I'm hanging up now. You're not scaring anyone.
The look on your face would say otherwise.
What did you say?
I think a better question to ask is whether I'm watching you from inside or outside the house. Looks like you have quite the dilemma on your hands.
You're not gonna kill me. I'm the fan favorite.
That doesn't matter. It's season two. I'm sure the audience will find a new character to love.
Damn it. Back and forth bullshit.
Shut him up.
Let's just hope we don't get slaughtered to death like those kids last year.
Oh my god, don't say that.
What?
Like, babe, that's not funny at all.
It's just like one of those episodes from Harper's Island. But, you know, I was kidding. Of course. Besides, if anything does happen, you have me to protect you. I don't bench press you after sex for no reason.
What? That's TMI, Jason.
Oh, don't be so prude, Zoe. We're in college now. This is the time to have fun and do things we'll regret for the rest of our lives.
Yeah, well, that doesn't sound so enticing when you already have things you regret for the rest of your life.
So should we start taking these bags up to you guys' room?
Yeah, sure. Come on, Zoe.
Hey, babe, what about your stuff?
That's what I have you for, silly. Let's go.
Nice to meet you.
So, how do you guys know each other?
We've been friends since middle school and all throughout high school. And now we're living together in college. How cool is that?
That's pretty cool, I guess. I mean, if you have a best friend.
No. I'm sure you'll find somebody that shares your same sense of style or lack thereof.
What did you say?
Hi. I'm Jason. Nice to meet you.
Hi. What's wrong, Amber?
I was putting clothes into the closet and I saw this huge spider and it really freaked me out.
Are you kidding me?
You scared the hell out of us.
Yeah, we thought you were being brutally murdered to death by some mass serial killer or something. What? We were all thinking it.
My boyfriend was killed by a serial killer.
I told you that wasn't funny to joke about.
I'm sorry. I had no idea. Well, I think I'm gonna head out now. Bring stuff to my dorm.
All right.
Catch you later. Later, Zoe. Bye, guys.
Is that your boyfriend?
Yeah, he is. I'm so sorry. He just doesn't think sometimes.
Yeah, I'm really sorry to hear about what happened to your boyfriend.
Don't mention it. He was just one of the many casualties that occurred last year.
Oh my God, was he one of those kids that got killed in that massacre?
Yeah, he was. His name was Steven. Steven Weinberg.
Oh, I think I remember reading his name in the paper.
Who reads the paper? I'm sorry. Sentimental moment.
Even though it's already been a year, I can't help but think that it's gonna happen again. Hence why I'm so jumpy.
Anyways, can someone please get that spider out of there?
What's up, guys? My name is Jason.
It's Logan.
Kyle.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
What you guys watching?
Scream 2.
Oh. You a big horror guy?
Does Michael Myers stalk babysitters on Halloween?
What?
Yeah, I'm a big horror fan.
Same. My inspirations are Michael Myers and Jason Voorhees when I'm working out.
Yeah, I look at them as sources of entertainment, but to each their own.
Entertainment? Nah, dude, those guys are ripped.
Yeah, they are very muscular, but actually I'm not watching it for entertainment purposes this time. I'm watching it for educational purposes, if you will.
What do you mean?
I mean, that deranged Emma chick decides to come back here and continue her killing spree this year. May as well brush up on my sequel knowledge.
Dude, for the last time, Emma is not coming back here this year.
Yeah, the chances of that happening are highly unlikely.
Well, I'm sure that's what the students here last year said. Look how that worked out for them.
That chick's been on the run for months.
Exactly. Why would she come back here and start killing out of the blue?
New school year?
Tons of new freshmen just waiting to get picked off.
Oh yeah? And what would her motive be?
What was Jason's motive in any of the Friday the 13th sequels? Crazy doesn't need a motive once psychotic has been established.
Since you're the horror genius, if Emma did decide to come back, what's the best way to survive the sequel massacre?
Well, what I can tell, sequels are always much more dark, more twisted. The stakes are much higher, which means that anyone can die at any point.
Well, that's encouraging.
That's if that Emma chick decides to come back.
I sure as hell hope not. So, is our other roommate here yet?
Yeah. He's in my bedroom doing God knows what.
Cool. Alright, I'm gonna go say hi.
Alright.
Later, nice meeting you, dude.
Hey, how's it going?
Do you often do that?
What, finger paint? Sometimes. Sometimes I put it all over my body and roll on the canvas. Oh, sorry. How rude of me. Name's Austin.
I think I'll just talk to you later when you're done painting. And have more clothes on.
I have a good feeling about this year.
Same. What could be better than going to college with your best friend?
Wanna watch TV?
Yeah, sure. Cheers. Hang on. Go back for a second.
What?
There. Doesn't that house look familiar?
Jasmine and Dean Tipton returned home Saturday evening to find a horrible scene in the middle of their street. Neighbors report calling police after hearing Lauren Tipton, Dean and Jasmine's daughter, screaming while being pursued by a hooded figure. Eyewitnesses report a gruesome scene of Miss Tipton's throat being slashed and multiple stab wounds to the face and torso area. Lauren was the sole survivor of the murders that took place at Fine Arts LA last fall. Police are speculating that Emma Fitzgerald, an accomplice in those murders, is responsible for Lauren's death. Police are currently trying to locate Miss Fitzgerald as they have been unable to do so over the past year because cops and slashers are completely fucking incompetent. Back to you in the studio, Ron.
Oh my God.
She can't be dead.
Are you guys okay?
No, not at all.
Lauren was our best friend.